Let's bring you an update from Chennai, where the Met forecast has talked about heavy to very heavy rainfall tomorrow as well. And it is not just going to be in 12, but 24 districts in Tamil Nadu, including Chennai and Puducherry as well. Impact is expected, including waterlogging, inundation, uprooting of trees and rise in levels of rivers, lakes and reservoirs. These are the Met forecast. At the moment, Chennai and suburb areas are witnessing a lot of waterlogging. Let's just cut across live to Sam Daniel and get a sense of how things stand there. Sam, over to you. Tell us where you are as of this moment and how bad is the situation there.
Sonal, we come to you from the G.N. Shetty Road near the T. Nagar area, the commercial hub of Chennai. It's beginning to rain, and as we speak now, the levels here are well above the ankle. And again, causing so much of hardship to residents here, to commuters. And as it begins to rain, it's going to get much more difficult in the hours to come. And the Met Office has just given another alert saying there's going to be very heavy rainfall over the next 24 hours. Across 24 districts in Tamil Nadu, including Chennai and neighbouring Puducherry. And that's a new worry. And with me, Mr. Srinivas and Mrs. Vidyalakshmi, thank you very much for your time. How do you find this kind of a situation every time it rains, particularly this time?
See, this is not new. Monsoons come every year. Depression at the bay forms every year. But we have to learn each time. But authorities as well as public, I don't think there's a lesson learnt any time, because it's only getting worse every year. We as public have some certain responsibilities, and authorities have certain responsibilities to, continue with what we do. Like waste segregation.
Right.
This is, I think it is mainly because the drains are blocked, totally blocked, because the wastes are not segregated and recycled properly.
Right. Mr. Srinivasan, the Chennai Corporation says they have cleaned up the stormwater drains at least 3 months early. They have pruned all the trees. This happens only because we have received very heavy rainfall, 21 centimeters on Saturday.
If that was the case, would we see this? It's only one night of heavy cloudburst on Saturday. If that is caused this much of a problem, imagine what happens if there's real heavy rain, which is what is predicted. The other unfortunate part is we had problems at our home, and we have been calling the corporation, all the helpline numbers, including engineer numbers, call centers. There's hardly any response. Half the time the number is not picked up. The time the number is picked up, there is an agent sitting at the other end, very religiously noting down our details, promising that somebody will get back. I can understand no action, but this is actually crisis time. So you can't be taking action now.
Right.
And one night of rain causing so much of flooding cannot be explained by just some heavy spell of rain.
Right.
Not possible. It is dereliction of duty and negligence.
You witnessed the 2015 deluge in Chennai.
Yeah.
How would you compare in terms of the impact and in terms of the government preparedness?
I would say any government which is there, any government should work together with the public. When the public is trying to do something, then they have to, understand that they are doing something, and they have to get together and continue with what the public is trying to do. But nothing has happened. Only the, for normal rains itself, we have such water stagnation. We have senior citizens in our house.
Have lessons been learned, you think?
Not yet. I wish a lesson is learned this year again.
Right.
Every year we say, okay, it's raining. Once upon a time, rains used to be, what fun. I still think they are fun. But then it's been made by us. We start fearing rains nowadays.
Right.
That's not right.
The COVID has brought about so much of changes in terms of the way we work, the way we study. How much this situation, the rain situation over the last 2 days in particular, has changed?
As she said, we have again got into the fear cycle, and we have the experience of 6 years ago. It was really bad for 4 days. Now it is just a one-day impact, and we are already scared for the next few days because we are having 2-3 other low pressures coming across over the balance of the week. So whatever we might have learned from COVID, and we seem to have respected the lessons there, hopefully we will learn and respect those lessons from this.
Right.
And we have a new government, of course, it's a government which has been in power earlier. less than 5 months. Let us hope that at least this government takes this issue seriously and we do proactive stuff to stop this problem and crisis from happening again. That's all we can hope for at this moment.
Thank you so much for talking to us, and certainly moments of anxiety and nightmare for many as it begins to rain, particularly a day after Chennai witnessed 21 centimeters of rain on Sunday. And authorities explained, Sonal, that the situation is only because there's been very heavy rainfall. They explained that the stormwater drains have a particular limit to carry a particular volume of water. And whenever this kind of situation continues, they say the situation will improve only after the rain subsides. And they point out in many parts of Chennai, the levels have receded. Many areas have become dry only because there was some respite last night. And they hope that this night too, there will be some kind of respite. Although the forecast says there could be very heavy rainfall leading to waterlogging and inundation, particularly in low-lying areas.